Hello everybody, welcome back. You're here with me in my art studio here in my home, and I just wanted to take a minute to say thank you so much for all the sweet feedback that you gave me in regards to my very first video weblog. Thank you for all the encouraging comments both on my blog and via personal email. I just needed it so much. I was so nervous about that. And I just really do thank you, and thanks for coming back and spending just a little bit of time with me. There's all kinds of faces that I picture on the other side of that screen, not the least of which I picture the young moms. And I have such a soft spot for mothers with little ones. I have four of my own, so I picture that young mom of, let's say five small children, who getting out to a middle of the day, midweek Bible study is just, it's an overwhelming thought. Or even getting out on a day like today, here in East Tennessee, it looks like we're going to get 2 or 3 days of rain back to back, which I'm grateful for. We really need it. But getting a whole lot of little children out in weather like that just isn't a practical thing. I also picture my friends who work in various different career fields, and how just taking off work in the middle of the day and going to a ladies' Bible study, or just even having some time for encouragement in the Lord, taking the time for that, just is not a practical thing. But maybe, just maybe, you can spend 5 minutes or 10 or 15 here with me. I'm going to try to make it short. I know it's so important. Number one rule, video, weblog, keep it short. So I'm going to really attempt to do that. So make sure you have your coffee. Very important. Last time I talked about all the silly places, all the different places I had allowed my sense of well-being to come from in years past, and I wanted to take a minute to just develop that idea a little more for you. I have allowed in years past my sense of well-being to come from my uber healthy diet, which, as you can see by the bucket of coffee that I carry with me at all times, I'm working on that, but it's not as uber healthy as it used to be. I had allowed my sense of well-being to come from my level of fitness. I had allowed my sense of well-being to rest in how perfectly clean my house could be. Silly things. And those were the little guys, the little bitty idols. The really big one was allowing my sense of well-being to come from my children's ability to live the Christian life, from my children's walk with God. I didn't realize that I had in fact placed my children's stewarding of their gifts, their use of their gifts, on equal terms as a sufficient substitute, I guess, for me stewarding my own gifts, properly stewarding them, faithfully stewarding the gifts that God had given me. I did not realize that my children and their walk with God was in fact not the same as my very own, very intimate, personal walk with God. So if they experienced perceived failure in their spiritual lives, I took it way too personally. In fact, there was a season in my life where I nearly completely lost my sense of well-being because I had not placed it in Christ alone. I had, in fact, allowed a very complex, very subtle form of idolatry to creep its way into my life, much like how I imagined the children of Israel in the Old Testament true story, where they took the bronze serpent on the pole, and that was a temporary solution, a gift, in fact, from God, a gift given to them, a solution for their healing. The children of Israel, as time went by, began to worship that temporary, secondary thing. They begin to worship it instead of God. And I had kind of done the same thing with motherhood. As wonderful as motherhood is, especially the years where you're raising little ones, preschool, school-age children, that's a temporary season. It's not a permanent state. That level of responsibility and nurturing isn't meant of your children isn't meant to be a permanent state. And I had taken that good thing, that secondary thing, and in fact pretty much made it the only thing. Like I said, I considered it my children's ability to live the Christian life as being the measuring stick for my own relationship with God. And so you always know that you're pursuing a secondary thing when you lose your sense of well-being. When your well-being is not firmly rooted and grounded in a very personal knowledge of the love of God for you, when it truly is not well with your soul, there's probably a measure of idolatry involved. And you know what? As Christians, we all struggle with that. Jesus said in Luke chapter 12, "Seek first this kingdom of God and all these other things that as human beings our hearts tend to yearn after, the things that we tend to seek after, all these other things will be added to you." Many different kinds of needs on all different sorts of levels, those things will be added to you if you seek first His kingdom. You know, in this kingdom of God, only one pursuit is allowed. Only one God on the throne. But the amazing thing, the wonderful thing is when that is made to be the only desire, His kingdom, our only desire, that desire is then fulfilled in us, and that desire is fulfilled for us by Christ Himself. So if we pursue Christ's righteousness instead of our own, which that fundamentally is what this kingdom of God is about, it's about the finished work of Christ. It is from Him and for Him and to Him and through Him are all things through Christ. So when we pursue His kingdom, our needs are met. All these things are added to us. And so just take a quick inventory check. What do you need added to you today? Beauty in all your relationships can be added to you. If you stop pursuing those relationships, whether as a mother with her children or marriage relationships, all these things that are wonderful gifts from God, but they're not the primary thing. They were never meant to be the primary thing. They were never meant to serve as any kind of substitute or benchmark of success. The only benchmark of success is, are you in Christ Jesus? But beauty in these other relationships, in these secondary areas, can be added to us. Just remember that beauty and perfection are not synonymous, not the same thing at all. You can have relationships that are imperfect, even wildly imperfect, and they can still be beautiful. They can still have the beauty of the Lord all over them. And I do speak from very personal experience. God has granted me in this season of my life beauty for ashes in my relationships with every single one of my children, but especially my sons. And I'm so blessed to be able to say that. It's not always an easy thing, but our relationship is very honest and it's very beautiful. And it's very gospel. What other need? What other thing do you need added to you? Every need, a roof over your head added to you. Food, that need is added to you. Clothing, added to you. Proverbs 31 says that strength is the virtuous woman's clothing. So daily strength for daily tasks added to you when you pursue His kingdom first. All your beautiful gifts are added to you. All these means, these instruments by which we bring Him praise, they're given to us as the beautiful gifts that they are, meant to be stewarded, meant to be administered for the glory of God. Our destiny is called out when we seek His kingdom and the righteousness of God that's found in Christ Jesus when we seek that first. So on a final note, I want to encourage you, yes, do engage spiritual disciplines, but because you're pursuing His kingdom first, not because disciplines can add to you anything that the finished work of Christ could not complete in you. You are complete in Him. But rather, discipline yourself because you're so valuable. Discipline yourself because in Christ Jesus, you are all that. You're so beautiful, and you're so gifted, and you're so valuable, and you're so full of destiny. And guess what? It does take discipline to steward the embarrassment of riches that are yours through Christ Jesus. And by the means of the beautiful gifts that He's given you, the ways that you bless the world. And there are specific lovely ways that you uniquely bless the world. You bless the people in your life. Those are your gifts. And they're meant to be for your joy, the things that bring you joy. And they're meant to bless others. And they're meant to bring glory to God. So seeking His kingdom as number one, the only thing. I don't even like to say number one. Nothing else beside Him. Finished work of Christ alone. He's everything. Thanks so much for hanging out with me just for a few minutes today. God bless you, and until next time.